Hello, how can I help you?
Hi, my name's Dave Bird. I have an appointment today. It's probably under Lil Dicky, actually. I'm a rapper, so.
Okay, and who are you here to see?
Snoop Dogg, says here, Snoop D-O-G-G.
Oh yeah, he's right down the hall. First door to your right. Give him a knock and he should be right with you.
Thanks, it's this door right here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Grab a seat.
Thanks, I'm Dave. Very nice to meet.
Dave, what it do? You can call me dog. Let me just check your sheet.
No problem, sir. Let me just say, I'm a big fan of the shit that y'all made. I can't lie, I've been thinking about this all day.
All good, there's a reason that we call Dave. Let me start with your background, where you come from.
Sure, I was undergrad down there in Richmond.
Before that.
Are you talking about my hometown?
Yeah.
I was born out of Philly, grew up in a little silly old town called Cheltenham. That's in the suburbs, upper middle wealth around.
So real shit, you ain't never had to struggle for much?
I wouldn't say it like that. We just had a different kind of trap.
Elaborate.
Well, I ain't never had a tool, but I had to be the man of school. Like I was doing shit I had to do. So when I finished undergrad, I'm cool and I could get whatever job I wanted.
But the job you wanted wasn't all that bumping.
Yeah, and I saw quick all the flaws that be coming when you grow up like that. When you been racing them rats, you ain't been making them raps.
Boo-hoo, what a hardship. How you pay to get the rap shit started?
Man, my bar mitzvah for money, but don't diss me, buddy. I wasn't one of them youngins up on the block who had nothing to lose. I must have wanted this a lot, I had something to choose.
Look at that, I can see there's something to prove up in your ass.
Yeah, I guess.
That's enough of the past. What makes you wanna do rap?
Oh my God, it's the best. Bitches let me drop on their breast. Literally, I can reinvent myself. I get a form to project myself. It's never boring. Every morning I wake up and try to best myself. I never gotta be suppressed or stealthy to express myself. It's kinda healthy.
Cool, now let me put you through a couple hypotheticals.
Sure.
In a club and a couple niggas threaten you.
I wouldn't do shit. And I don't even get what they gotta do with this.
Shut the fuck up. Rap's like life. If you wanna do this, then you won't get far acting like a little bitch.
Nah, that's my niche. Don't get offended by this. But that's the market y'all miss. That's the target I'll hit. And that's the heart of my pitch. I wanna do this whole thing different.
The fuck you mean you wanna do the whole thing different?
I think, like, you know, traditionally people have been doing the job, the same kind of way for a long time.
But traditionally speaking, this shit works, right?
No, I get that, but I just think, like, you know, you don't know if it could be working even better. And I think you should look at me as an opportunity to find that out. I don't mean any disrespect by that. I'm just saying I have a different background, like a different perspective, way of looking at things than your typical applicant.
So what are your biggest strengths?
My flow is crazy, I can switch that amazing. For example, I could be like, ain't nobody fucking with Lil Dicky when he get up on this shit and spit his nigga ridiculous. Ribbon this shit like it's never been did, and the rhythm is never predictable, cause I can switch and deliver this shit in whatever cadence you bitches prefer.
Alright, I get it.
Top of that, lyrically, I'm pretty damn clever.
Go.
Got a long bottom bitch called a hoe Neville.
Bro.
And I blow from the junk, Derrick Rose knee.
Oh.
You can say I'm pretty smart, how I know better. And y'all been winning like Vistorius, it's no feat. Bro, I could go on and on, I'm taking over and they mad like father-in-laws.
Okay, enough of the punchline. That ain't showing me you different than the other guys.
Well, I don't know if they can run it like that, but ain't nobody else doing funny tight rap.
What's that?
Well, I could tell a story about my morning watching Boy Meets World and jerking off to the Pangalorm. It's like the 14-year-old of Panga.
Oh, this shit like a joke to you? I don't get it.
Nah, it ain't like that. I just happen to be a nutty, abundantly funny type of individual, like as a guy. So when I get up on the mic, I ain't finna just lie. Real recognize real, right?
Yeah, I guess. So what you trying to do 5 years from now? Tell me about the dude.
Well, I don't care about the money, like it's the respect that I'm wanting. Honestly, I just wanna be one of the greats, where they gotta bring a poya up every debate. I don't wanna lead the game the same.
In a nutshell, what's your legacy?
Well, I wanna be the dude that came in and made a stand-up rap with the random rap and a man like that. For the people that was anti-rap, yeah, the fans of rap started to recognize the anti-rap is ironically one of the real brands of rap left.
That shit sound pretty damn complex.
I guess I wanna be the best, I just wanna do it my way and turn a whole game sideways to show people you ain't gotta be resigned to the highway. You can make a path while these motherfuckers drive straight.
I ain't mad at that.
Well, thanks, man, that's my plan of attack. Just let me in and I'ma rap the plaques, and I ain't about to win them back to back. I'm about to win them like it's back to back to back to back to back till I stop rapping.
You ain't even sold a damn album yet,
true.
That's a lot of talk from a wily vet, let alone a young rook, nigga.
You misread me.
Nah, this ain't a book, nigga.
Well, that's one of my flaws. I'm too competitive, dog.
Nah, you just fucking repetitive, dog. I get it, you trying to be better than all, but you aren't shit into Jenna's involved.
I get that, I gotta prove myself.
No shit, you ain't done shit.
But think about that, dog. Only doing this a couple of years, one taping them like this.
This shit is alright for your first shit, but you don't know if it's your worst shit.
Well, you don't think finding out would be worth it?
It might be, it might not. But I'ma put your ass to work, kid.
Wait, like I have the job? Like, really?
Well, one more thing. Let me see if you can put a hook together. What would you do for the hook for this song?
You want me to make a hook up right now?
Do I look like the type of nigga that like repeating himself?
Okay.
Man, do the hook.
I'm about to be professional. Homie, I'm professional. Maybe like a low voice type thing?
Nigga, that shit is garbage, man.
Well, you know, I feel like there might have been some upside to it, but I'm not good at thinking of things on the spot like that. Don't y'all normally, like, outsource for that kind of thing sometimes?
Sometimes. But you know, That was some next level dog shit right there.
Yeah, you know, I'm just way better when I get to think things through, have like my dual screen action, that kind of thing.
Whatever, man. You trying to smoke a blunt?
Right now?
Yeah.
Sure.
Dope. Juanita, bring some weed in here, please. Thank you.
You got it, Snoop. I'll be right there.
Thanks, Juanita. Super nice woman.
Nigga, why does everything you say sound so soft?
I really don't want to be spoken to like that, so.
Yeah, whatever.
Thanks.
Hey, I got y'all weed.
Damn, that's some great-looking weed. It's just so early.
Can I get you guys anything else while I'm here? Coffee, tea, head, bottled water?
Did you just say head?
Yeah, you ain't never got no head before?
I mean, it just feels like a lot right now.
Okay.
But what kind of tea do you guys have?
We got mint, raspberry, Earl Grey, English breakfast.
Actually, I'll take head.
I knew your little dirty ass.